Yes.
All right. And Mike and Susan, how are you doing?
Good.
Oh, please. We haven't said much. I've said to them, but I haven't said much. So tell me, how are you feeling here?
Good.
Okay. I'd like to welcome you both, in fact, all of you, you and your friends, on behalf of the management and staff of the Sandals Halcyon Beach Resort. By extension, I want to welcome you on behalf of the government and all the people of St. Lucia.
Thank you.
I really want to ask you, aren't you feeling welcomed by the people of St. Lucia?
Yes.
We are,
most
definitely.
You are?
Most definitely.
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
And so we are extremely grateful and happy to have you here to celebrate this special occasion in your lives, recognizing that you came from real far across the seas. I don't know which state, but I imagine it's from the U.S.
Yes, yes. Ohio.
And the state of Ohio. And for this, I must say, you are from Ohio also?
Yes.
We are truly, truly grateful. Now, I ask that you leave your footprints here on our sands to cherish, and I'm sure you will take fond memories of St. Lucia with you.
Yes, we will.
You will?
We will,
yes. Yes, we will.
And so we gather here today, Oceanside, to have you, Randy, and you, Holly, renew your enduring bonds of marriage. We also gather to witness the reaffirmation of your vows of marriage after 24 wonderful years together. Now, I must say that after 24 years of marriage, that is, and I want to recognize the date as 22nd of June, 1991. Am I correct on that?
Correct.
22nd June?
Yep.
Yeah. You two have learned that happiness is not something that just happens. Okay? It doesn't just happen from out of the world. This is what you did. A good marriage must be created. It must be. And I think that's what you've done. You have the art of creativity in your marriage. It is, and some of the things, the ingredients that make a good marriage, some of the things I'm going to make a short reflection of them, and I'm sure that is what you have done that makes it so good. In the art of marriage, first thing that comes up, it says, it's at no time taking each other for granted. Now, if you disagree with me, you can say that. Let's have a discussion. It is having a mutual sense of values and common objectives. It is standing together, the two of you standing together and facing the world. It is you forming a circle of love that gathers the whole family together. It's doing things for each other, not in the attitude of duty or sacrifice, but all in the spirit of joy. This is some of the things that you, I think, in the reflection, you need to, that cause you to be enjoying 24 years of marriage today. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in every thoughtful way. It's not looking for the perfection in each other, but it is cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, and of course, a great sense of humor. Please don't let your marriage be a boring one. You leave that to the mortuary, okay? It is establishing, and that is what resonates. It is establishing a relationship in which the independence is equal, the dependence is mutual and the obligation is reciprocal. This is very strong. Alright? And you need, I think I needed to mention it. Now, I do a lot of reading from a guy called Merrill Fishman. I like his writing. He's a poet. He writes very strong poems. And this one I chose because of, for your ceremony, I decided to quote him with some, and just a short paragraph that he said in his writings. He says, "You know me as I really am, and I know you truly. Not even as we know ourselves, but to the very core. But to the very core of our beings. And we see the good and the bad, accepting it all with joy. And from this time on, our souls are locked in harmony. I have become you, you have become me, and we call each other love." I'm struck by it, you know, these words. So that's why I wanted to share that with you, Randy and Holly. So, Randy and Holly, with this reaffirmation ceremony here before us, we pray that your lives together will continue to be blessed with health, with peace, with happiness for you and your children, Dylan and Noel, and of course for the rest of your family and your friends, especially those who are here with you. And so today we pray that you will continue to live a very much longer life that you have lived together, enjoying each other till you all grow old together until the end of your days. Let it be as you are, trodding this world with love and with happiness. So, I now ask that you turn and join both hands with each other for the exchange of your vows. Okay, I have a few words. In fact, you shall say a few words that I have prepared for you to say to each other. Beginning with you, Randy. As you look to Holly, follow my promptings and say to her, call her name, Holly.
Holly.
I love and support you for all that you are.
I love and support you for all that you are.
And all that you are becoming with each passing day.
And all that you are becoming by each passing day.
From the day we met.
From the day we met.
I have loved you.
I have loved you.
Adored you.
Adored you.
And cherished you.
And cherished you.
I will continue to love you.
I continue to love you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
And I'd like you to answer those questions to Holly. The first being answering I do, and the other two saying I will to Holly. And so, Randy, with this understanding, do you, Randy, take Holly to be your beloved wife?
I do.
I should say to continue to be your beloved wife.
I do.
Will you continue to be a tender and a faithful husband?
I do.
Will you continue to love and cherish her in sickness and in health, for richer and for poorer, for better and for worse, and that you'll keep yourself only unto her?
I do.
And Holly, I'd like you to call his name Randy.
Randy.
I love and support you.
I love and support you.
For all that you are.
For all that you are.
And all that you are becoming.
And all that you're becoming.
With each passing day.
Each passing day.
From the day we met.
From the day we met.
I have loved you.
I have loved you.
Adored you.
Adored you.
And cherished you.
And cherished you.
I will continue to love you.
I will continue to love you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
And with this understanding, Holly, do you continue to take Randy as your beloved husband?
I do.
Will you continue to be a tender and a faithful wife?
I will.
Will you continue to love and cherish him in sickness and in health, for richer and for poorer, for better and for worse, and that you'll keep yourself only unto him?
I will.
Thank you. And you have your own words to say to each other.
Yes.
Beginning with Randy. Who wants to go first?
I will go first.
Randy, use both hands and connect with him while he stays with us.
Okay.
Just something small. Theta's only mark 24 years of marriage, but more than half of our lives spent together as a couple. Our journey started so many years ago. I found such a wonderful woman, best friend. It has been an amazing journey. Raised two wonderful children and so many days of happiness. Now that we are starting our second chapter in life, I stand in front of you to renew our vows, to honor my wife, my best friend, and show my devotion and love Always.
We have been together for a very long time, but the time has gone by so quickly. It seems like one day we were in high school, and here we are with two grown-up children. I just want to thank you for taking such good care of us for all these years and working so hard to take care of us. You're not only my husband, but you are my best friend. You're my soulmate, and you are a great dad and an even better husband. We have gone through a lot together and a lot of losses, and without you, I don't think I could have made it through. You really stepped up and helped me through those times. We've had a wonderful life together so far. Thank you for all that you do. I love you completely, and I know that we'll always be together.
Can you please, please? Uh-huh. You can tuck it in his pocket.
Thanks.
Okay. Not too close. Yeah. Please, both hands. Let me get some reverence. Huh? Randy and Holly, at this point, I would like to say here before me, and before you and your friends who gathered here, are these two beautiful wedding rings that you have been wearing for the last 24 years to signify your bond of marriage. I want to say to you that these wedding rings are only the outward and the visible sign of the inward and the spiritual bond which unites your two loyal hearts in endless love. So may the the substance of these rings represent the love between you both that will continue to grow and will also glow and shine with increasing luster as the years continue to grow. You shall rededicate those rings with love, and you shall continue to wear it with more love. So, Randy, take Holly's ring, place it in your left third finger, and say to her, Holly. Take this ring.
As a symbol.
Of my everlasting love.
As my everlasting love.
And faithfulness.
And faithfulness.
May it be. A permanent reminder. Of the commitment that I made to you.
My commitment I made to you.
24 years ago.
Kiss
the finger. Yeah.
Randy,
take this ring
as a symbol
of my everlasting love
and my faithfulness.
May it be
a permanent reminder
of the commitment that I made to you
24 years ago today.
Turn and face me now. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, do we have an audience for them? Well, you have certainly, in fact, renewed your vows of marriage before me and before your friends here. And so it gives me a great honor one more time to re-pronounce you as husband and wife. You may seal this with a mighty kiss. Give it to them again, ladies and gentlemen, one more time as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Ludwig. All right.
Okay.
Congratulations,
thank you,
man.
Thank
well
you.
Done. Congratulations,
thank
Mrs.
Thank
God. Well done.
That's very nice.
Good. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
All the best.
Thank you.
Thanks, sir, for helping me out. If I couldn't make it out,
so
let's give it
some.
The roof right over our heads.
job from Bible bread. Is this love, is this love, is this love, is this love that I'm feeling? Is this love, is this love, is this love, is this love that I'm feeling? Take